Halasana. Do Salamba Sarvangasana 1 with a firm chin lock. Release the chin lock, lower the trunk slightly, moving the arms and legs over the head and resting the toes on the floor. Tighten the knees by pulling up the hamstring muscles at the back of the thighs and raise the trunk. Place the hands in the middle of the back and press it to keep the trunk perpendicular to the floor. Stretch the arms on the floor in the direction opposite to that of the legs. Hook the thumbs and stretch the arms and legs. Interlock the fingers and turn the wrist so that the thumbs rest on the floor. Stretch the palms along with the fingers. Tighten the arms at the elbows and pull them from the shoulders. The legs and the hands are stretched in opposite directions, and this stretches the spine completely. While interlocking the fingers, it is advisable to change the interlock. Suppose that the right thumb touches the floor first, maintain the position for a minute, then release the grip and bring the left thumb first on the floor. Follow the interlock fingers by fingers and stretch out the arms for the same length of time. This will lead to harmonious development and elasticity of both the shoulders, elbows, and wrist. Come back to Salamba Sarvangasana 1. And relax. Repeat the complete Halasana once again. Step by step, the effect of Halasana is the same as that of Sarvangasana 1. In addition, The abdominal organs are rejuvenated due to contraction. The spine receives an extra supply of blood due to the forward bend, and this helps to relieve backache. Cramps in the hands are cured by interlocking the palms and fingers. People suffering from stiff shoulders and elbows, lumbago, and arthritis of the back find relief from this asana. Gripping pain in the stomach due to wind is also relieved, and the lightness is felt immediately. This asana is good for people with a tendency of high blood pressure. Come back to Salamba Sarvangasana one. And relax.